Hi guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel. For today's video, I'm filming a makeup and skincare haul. I don't think I've ever done a NYKAA haul on my channel, and that's so surprising because I'm always shopping off NYKAA. So today here we are. I'm sharing a huge NYKAA haul and also a sugar cosmetics haul. And it's the sugar one is small, the NYKAA one is more big, and I've shopped for some products that I use and love, and so I had to get refills of those and some new products that I wanted to test out. So if you're interested to know what I got, then please keep on watching. Okay, so let's start with this big box from NYKAA. I actually had two boxes, but I merged everything inside this particular one box and I unpacked whatever because I started using my products that I needed to use. So first up, I have over here my absolute favorite shampoo. This is the OGX Argan Oil of Morocco shampoo, and this is a different variant. I usually get the other one. This is extra strength, hydrate and repair. Both of them are Argan Oil of Morocco. This is the first time I'm using the extra strength variant, and I tried it two times already and I do love it. It's the same thing. I love this particular shampoo. I actually also use the same moisturizing treatment, which also I had to refill. So both of these products I got from NYKAA. The shampoo costs around, if I'm not wrong, it's 725. Yes, it's exactly 725. And the conditioner is also 725. So both these products are 725 each. Both of them belong to the same range. This is not a conditioner, it's a moisturizing treatment. So it's more like a spa situation. They smell great and they're great for my hair because my hair is super dry and it can get very frizzy. But when I use these products, my hair is super smooth all week and it doesn't get frizzy in the sun, does not damage my hair with the sun. Both these products are sulfate free, and if you have curly, frizzy hair or dry hair, you will love these shampoos. They have a lot of products from their range that you can select. I've tried so many shampoos in the past and so many conditioners and tested out everything else also that has argan oil, but particularly nothing worked for my hair, and so I've come back to this and I'm not switching up again. So yeah, these are like my holy grail shampoo and conditioner. The next thing I bought is this huge tub of Vaseline Coco Glow Moisturizing Cream. The Coco variant in Vaseline lotion is my favorite one because it smells so good. I love the smell on this. I've already opened it and this is like a thick cream. It's not a lotion. The one that comes in the vertical bottle is the body lotion. And I also have the petroleum jelly in the cocoa butter variant. So I love the smell on this and it's a very big tub. It's more thick and I think it takes more time to like really massage into your skin than the body lotion. The body lotion sinks in faster. But this, you get a lot more with this, and it's just for 160. I picked it up. All of this had some of the other discount on it, so I picked it up for 160 bucks. The next refill product I got was the Kama Ayurveda Pure Rose Water Face and Body Mist. I love this stuff and I already ran out of my first bottle. And now that the summers and this weird climate is hitting, this is so refreshing for the skin. Whenever my skin is inflamed or irritated, I just spritz rose water over it and then apply a lightweight moisturizer and go to bed. So I need this in my life. And the smell, since it has this Ayurvedic rose water smell, it's very calming to the senses. So this is like 300 for this small bottle. Since Kama Ayurveda is on the luxury side, it is expensive. If you want to get rose water, I highly recommend this. Another refill I got was the Nivea Whitening Smooth Skin Deodorant, the underarm roll-on. This is an absolute must in my life. Like, I don't sweat too much from my underarms. I do sweat a lot, but I don't sweat from my underarms specifically. But I feel like all because of this, because the 3 days I did not have this, like, that my previous one got over and I was waiting for this to come in the mail, my underarms were stinking. Like, I was using another deodorant, the spray variant deodorant of another company, and still the body odor could not stay at bay, you know. And I hate body odor from myself or from others. I can't take it. And this particular roll-on does not let me sweat at all. It keeps me dry underneath my arms all day. It is alcohol free and so does not cause hyperpigmentation on the underarms, and it also makes you smell fresh all day. All day means like from day to night, I never have to reapply the roll-on. It has very long lasting power, so I love this. I don't want to try any other roll-on. This does just the job for me. And any other roll-on that you're using, if it has alcohol inside, I highly do not recommend you to test any roll-on which has alcohol because that will cause hyperpigmentation for your underarms. This particular one says whitening, which I don't really like because it doesn't make your underarms fairer or anything like that. It just does not make it darker. That's the only thing it does. Okay, one last refill and then three new products that I shopped. So another refill I got is my Maybelline Baby Lips Cherry Kiss Lip Balm. I love this one. This, the original Baby Lips, is the OG, okay? There's no other Baby Lips that's good or as good as this. Like, I've tried every other Baby Lips. The Chubby Steak, the Alia Bhatt Collection, the color variants, everything, the Neon, and all of them suck. All of them are not moisturizing enough. They are very weirdly pigmented and make your lips look very ugly, and I don't like them. And so I'm back to square one. I'm never testing another Baby Lips out. This is the Baby Lips color variant, but it is SPF 20 lip balm with 16-hour moisture and translucent color and shine. So it just gives a little bit of a tint. And my favorite one is the Berry Crush and also the Cherry Kiss. So this time I got the Berry Crush, and the Cherry Kiss is also nice. And the antioxidant berry in this one is the transparent one, which has no color to it. So if you like a no color lip balm, that one is pretty great and smells and tastes really good too. So, but this one is my absolute favorite. I keep on buying Baby Lips literally every month. It's my favorite lip balm. Okay, so some of the new makeup I got the new Rimmel London Match Perfection Foundation, the 24-hour moisture hydration foundation. It's a foundation I'm wearing on my skin right now because I'm testing it out for a video, which I don't know if it'll go up before this. If it goes up before the NYKAA haul, then I'm gonna leave it in the description section, the link to that video, and you can check out how I feel about this foundation. For now, I'm not going to say much because I'm still testing it out. But yeah, I got this because I've not tried any of the Rimmel London product, and I've heard a lot of good things from like European YouTubers about Rimmel foundation, so I really want to test it out. The next product I got, which was a super hype in the market, this is the Dear Darling Lip Tint from Etude House. Etude House came to India sometime back, and this was like the most raved about product. This is their Water Gel Tint. Water gel tint, and this comes in this cute ass ice cream packaging, which is so cute. I love the packaging on this. It's super small, like you can see it's like smaller than my ear. I have ear comparisons when it comes to size, but it's super duper small, and the ice cream car top part opens, and the applicator on this is exactly like a lipstick dope foot applicator, very teeny tiny. I tried it on last night. I just applied on my bare lips, and the color I got was PK004. It doesn't have a name to it, but this is a light pink color, and it honestly did not show up on my lips. I've not tried it out just as much, but for my first impressions, I did not like it. It's a water gel tint. It's very lightweight. It was watery in nature and went away, like the watery feeling went away very quickly, and the color literally did not show up. So I think you need to go a little darker. I don't know how it will perform on my cheeks. I have not tried it on my cheeks yet. But for the packaging, it's super cute, but it is priced at $450. Etude House products are a little pricey. That's why I did not try much from it, because they are not very exciting with the formula. They are more exciting on the packaging. So I want to try this out because of the packaging, and I did not like it that much. And the last product I got from NYKAA was the Lakme Forever Matte Liquid Lip Color. I got in the shade Nude Dream 08. Because a lot of y'all, I asked in the Maybelline Sensational Matte review if y'all wanted me to review the Lakme one as well, and there were quite a lot of positive replies in the comments, so I decided to purchase one. I'm gonna get one more so that I can do a proper review video and swatch them. The color in the tube looks really great. Let's do a hand swatch. I've not really even opened it. It's priced at $295, so it's a very affordable lipstick. That's why I want to do a proper review, because if it's a good formula, then a lot of y'all can invest in this lipstick. And Lakme usually gets their lipstick formulas really good. So the applicator is something like this. You get very little amount. Let me see how much you get. It's just 5.6 ml, not a lot of product in this. Ooh, this color is gorgeous. I love the color. So it has a lot of pigmentation to it. It was one swipe application. I will try it out on my lips, and if I like the formula, then get another one and do a proper review. If I do not like it, I will mention on my Instagram. So if you follow me there, you will come to know how I feel about this lipstick once I try it to college. Okay, so that was all about the NYKAA parcel. Now next, let's dive into the sugar parcel that I got. This is not PR. I purchased These two products from Sugar. I bought it from Sugar. It's available on NYKAA as well because I want to try their foundation out. And their foundation was running a discount on the website, and that's why I went onto their website and got it. So I got the drop, the base serum foundation. I got the shade 52 Coretto. And I love Sugar's packaging. Like, the girls that are made on Sugar's packaging, really unique packaging. The number 52 is right here. And I was really surprised at the size of this foundation. I thought it would be bigger. This is like literally the same thing that happened with the NYX drop control foundation for me, that I thought it would be so much bigger, but it's super small, and surprisingly it has the same packaging as the NYX one. But of course, if the formula is good, I picked this up on discount, and so it was just $637, which is very affordable. And there were a lot of shades to offer. I want to do a separate review video on this. This is a serum based foundation, so it is more on the light to medium coverage, and I want to try this out because mostly I do full coverage reviews, and this is the summer season, it's a weird climate, so I thought I would go in for more lighter coverage foundation reviews. So mostly I'm going to test this out next month, since I'm doing the Rimmel foundation review this month. Let me know in the comments if you're interested to see what I think about this. I really like the packaging though, like the frosted glass packaging. I am a big sucker for frosted glass foundation packages, and the drop of course makes it a lot easier. The only thing is that you can't travel because it's glass. But I personally like traveling with glass bottles which have like these drop applicators than the pump, because the pump gets ruined in the aircraft, like the pressure difference ruins the pump. That's what happened with my Fenty foundation. But the drop system cannot go wrong in the aircraft because no pressure difference will affect that drop applicator. So yeah, I really did not like the size of that, but I hope that the formula makes up for it. And the next thing I got from Sugar is a lip liner. It's called Lipping on the Edge Lip Liner, and I got the shade 02 Wooden Nude. I only own one lip liner in the nude section, and that's from Faces, and they stopped making that one. So every time I use it in a video, people are upset because they cannot get their hands on it. So I decided to invest finally in a new lip liner. This is, like I said, 02 Wooden Nude, and it's a very pretty packaging. I love the black, and the color is so gorgeous. I love it. It's more of a peachy nude. It's not a brown nude. There is a darker color than this. It's called Terracotta, and this is more peachy, but it looks beautiful on the lips, and it's very convenient when a lipstick is washing you out to apply like a lip liner and then apply that particular lipstick on top, which washes you out, so it won't do that, and then you can make the most of your lipsticks. The formula, I don't know how long wearing it is, but it's very creamy and smooth and glides on perfectly. Does not like the pencil scratchy feeling you do not get, and also you get a sharpener with it, which is a very good quality sharpener. I was so surprised at the sharpener's quality. It's like it has a dual thing. So this is what the sharpener looks like. It has the Sugar logo, and you can like remove it, and it has both, like for the thicker pencils, the chubby sticks, and the thinner lip liners and cudgels. So it's a very cute sharpener. Again, all of these links I'm gonna leave in the description section. That was all for my haul for today. This is the first time I'm doing a makeup and skincare haul. Let me know if you guys enjoyed and you want to see more hauls. Leave them in the comments below. Which was your favorite product and what do you want me to test out in a separate video? Let me know that as well in the comments below, and I will do that for you guys. If you guys liked the video, then please don't forget to hit the like button. Follow me on Instagram if you're not already doing that, because a lot of mini reviews here and there, I tend to do that on Instagram. So follow me there. My handle is right here, and I will see you guys in my next video. Until then, please don't forget to subscribe. Click on the bell, and yeah, I'll see you next Sunday. Bye. Love you all.